When I was students of Joseph College. Today we want to continue on our e-learning, or I call it tutorial class. So last time that we met, we actually did a revision, a little revision on the quadratic equation. We use the factorization methods, and we also make use of completing the square methods. And I remember I told you that that's not only the two methods that we have. We also have a general formula, and we also have a graphical methods. But today, because that one is just revision, I want to start a new topic, a fresh topic. So today I want to take you through what we call simultaneous equation. What you need to understand about simultaneous equation is that we are talking about a point, a coordinate point of x and y that are known, that you must look for. And for it to be written that equation must have equal sign. For example, if I have x plus y is equal to 0, this is an equation, isn't it? Now, I have some other equation, 2x plus y is equal to 3. This is also what? Equation. Now, the variable involved here, x and y, it is what you must solve simultaneously. That's what I call simultaneous equation. You solve it simultaneously, at least at the same time. So you get x, then after you get y. Or you get y, then after you what? You get what? X. Anyone can come first. Either x first before y, or y before what? Before x. So, that is just a little introduction about that. Now, we have methods. What are the methods we can use to solve simultaneous equation? That is, how can I go about it? If I see an equation that is, I need to solve simultaneously, which methods should I use? So we have, number one, we have elimination method. Number two, we have substitution method. Then, number three, we have graphical method. I'm going to explain the three. Graphical method. These are the three major methods that we can use to solve a simultaneous equation. So the first one, elimination. From what elimination? It means canceling. It means kill. It means destroy. It means remove. So it means wipe out, wipe off. So it doesn't matter. The elimination, the word elimination is just an English word. That is, you can eliminate, you can remove a variable and leave the rest. Leave the other. You can kill a variable. You can cancel a variable. You can clean a variable for the other. So that's elimination. Substitution, that is, means remove one and put it inside the other. As you are removing it, you are making this particular variable the subject of the formula, then you put it inside the equation. Then graphical method, this one require use of graph. This one require use of graph, where you have a pencil, cleaner, eraser, and the rest. You have complete masset. You need complete masset and your graph sheet for you to achieve success concerning graphical methods. So, we're taking the method one after the other. Now, firstly, elimination methods. Let's start with elimination methods. I told you that elimination methods is a way in which we remove one variable, either by canceling or by any other way, to make sure that we have other variable. So, I want to establish that. Now, I told us also again that it will be required of us two variables here, probably x and y. In mathematics, we do use x and y. It's too common. It can be a and b. It can be q and x. It can be s and t. It can be u and v. It can be z and any other variable, y, whatever. In as long as it's between a to z, all are regarded as what? As a variable in my mathematics. Okay, now, for example, let's take example one. Example 1, Example one, let's take a question. We have a question here. 2x minus y is equal to 0. Then we have another 3x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to 0. 2x minus y is equal to 0. 3x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to what? Is equal to 0. Now, the first one you call it equation what? Equation 1. The second one you call it equation what? Equation 2. So, now, in simultaneous equation, you have two, at least two equations. It can be three, but at higher level. So, you meet that. But at your own level, you have maximum and minimum of two equations. That is 1 and 2. Now, equation 1 is 2x minus y is equal to 0. Equation 2 is 3x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to what? Is equal to 0. Now, you start, we want to use elimination method. Using elimination methods. Now, we will look at the coefficient of x here is 2. The coefficient of x here in equation 2 is 3. The coefficient of y here is minus 1. The coefficient of y here is plus 2. Now, this is just a constant value which can be transferred and make it to be equal to what? 5 here. Because of the minus, we turn to what? Plus 5 here. So, now, we want first thing to look at which variable should I eliminate. Which one should I remove for the other? Is it y or x? Or is it x or y? So we must determine that. Now, for easy access and for easy understanding, I will suggest as teacher for you that the one that you have that you see with minus and plus is very easy. All you need to do is do that. You make sure that the coefficient of the variable you want to eliminate are the same with different sign. If I have 2 here, I have 2 here, but one must be plus, one must be minus. If I have plus 2y, if I have plus 2x, then I cannot eliminate that. That's why the fact that I have the same coefficients. Now, I must have minus 2y, minus plus 2y, minus 2y, plus 2y. You know that one will give us automatically 0. Are you there? Now, what should I do to achieve that? Okay, for equation 1, I can say, if I multiply equation 1 by something, I will have the same variable if I multiply equation 2 by this another value. Now, if I have minus y, if I multiply equation 1 by, let's just try an error, if I multiply equation 1 by 2, are you there? You know this 2 or 2x here will turn to 4x. No, then the y here will turn to what? Minus 2y. Then, times 0 will give you 0, isn't it? Then coming back to this, if I multiply this one by, let's say, equation 2 by 1, then 1 times 3x will give me 3x, 1 times 2y will give me 2y, then 1 times minus 1 will still give me what? It still give me 5, isn't it? Minus 5. So with that, mean that I will have the same coefficient for y in equation 1 and for y in equation 2. Therefore, I can remove y totally and can solve for my x. So therefore, you see, multiply equation 1 by 2 and equation 2 by 1. When you see equation 1, you multiply the whole equation by 2. So what do I have? 2 into bracket 2x minus y is equal to 0. That is your equation. You see equation what? You can call it equation 3, you like. Can use your figure, 1, 2, 3. Now, for equation 2, this is equation 2, you multiply everything by what? By 1, 3x plus 2y minus, try to transfer this once and for all. Then, is it, equation what? Call that one equation what? Equation 4. Roman figure 4. So, we have the something that is a little bit clear. So what do we do now? We open a bracket with the what? With the number. 2 times 2x will give me what? 4x. Then 2 times minus y will give me what? Minus 2, 2y. then 2 times 0 will give me what? It give me 0, isn't it? Now, for this one, 1 times 3x, I will have what? 3 or 3x. Then 1 times 2y, I will have what? Plus what? Plus 2 or 2y. Then 1 times 5, I will have what? I will have a 5, isn't it now? So, we have, you do the summation of the equation 1 and equation 2 together. So, I have 4x plus 3x minus 2y plus 2y, then is equal to 0 plus 5. Summation of all the equations, both 1 and 2 together. So 4x plus 3x give me what? 7x, then minus 2x minus 2y plus 2y give me 0. So I have what? Plus 0 is equal to what? 5. Isn't it now? So I have 7x is equal to what? Is equal to 5. Isn't it now? Mind you, what you actually want to get is what? Is x, not 7x. So what do you do to remove this 7? You say divide both sides by what? By 7. So divide both sides by 7. So we have 7x over 7 is equal to 5 over 7. 7 times 7 here, is it now? So I have x to be equal to 5 over 7. That is for x. Now, you need to get what? You need to get y also. To look for y, what do you do? Then, since we have the x, it's very easy for us to get the y. So, to just write, to get y, so we have, to get y, you substitute, put x is equal to 5 over 7 into equation 1. It can be 1, 2, whatever. It doesn't matter, it has to be 2, 1 alone. You can put in equation 1, you can substitute in equation 2. Even if you have equation 3, you can put it there. Just for you to get what? Other variables. You are going to achieve the same results. So I want to establish that. So to get our y now. One of the equation is 2x minus 2y. One of the equation is 2x minus y is equal to 0. This is equation 1. So now whenever you see x in equation 1, you put x is equal to 5 over 7. So I have 2 into bracket, this is x, so 5 over 7 minus y, isn't that, is equal to 0. 2 times 5, we have 12, oh, this is over 1 like this, so 12 over 7 minus, 2 times 5, we have 10, isn't it, mistake, so 1 times 7, we have what, 7, is equal to minus y, is equal to 0, isn't it now, so 10 over 7, is equal to what? Y. Transfer y to the other side, isn't it? You can now say that therefore x is equal to 5 over 7, comma y is equal to what? Is equal to 10 over 7. If you substitute this and this back to any of the equation, either equation 1 or equation 2, you are going to have 0. You put in equation 1, you have 0. You put in equation 2, the same thing, you have what? You have 0. This is the elimination method. Mind you, we remove x, we remove y, I mean, to get x. Now, since we have our x to be equal to 5 over 7, then we return back that x to equation 1. We substitute x is equal to 5 over 7 to equation 1 for us to do the little arithmetic and get our y. So it's very easy, but just that you cannot get the same two variables at the same time. You have to solve it one after the other. We remove one for one.